Not much.
Well, their last two picks. I don't know. I feel like they're pretty flexible in the support options. Like, Tycho, Brightwing, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But who's your warrior? Is it Varian? Is it Johanna? Is it Muradin?
I don't know if I like Varian versus comp as much as the last comp, because Tychus and Polly, and they've got the responses. You know, that blow-up style doesn't work against Medivh as well. So they're going to do it, though. Okay. This is almost identical to the way they approached Sky Temple before. Only difference is Rhaegar rather than Malfurion. It's all about the taunt on a single target and the blow-up of Leaving Zeratul, while Falstad maintains that global pressure, lane clear.
We've seen a lot of Zeratul play, right?
Mm-hmm.
In HGC, but we don't really see it without some type of combo off that, whether it be an Apoc or a Ring of Frost. Like, there's normally something, and this is twice now they've run it without any follow-up. It is strictly, it'll be a disengage tool, or it will be something that you're just like, all right, we're going to go in, and that's pretty much it.
It's interesting. Like,
you can follow up on it. This camera thing is makes me sad.
Well, the struggle, J-Hal.
So I'll cast off Skype on a half-second delay.
Level 1 talents. We do have Unfurl or Hyper. Excuse me, I got the icons confused in my head. Yeah, pretty much standard.
Alright, going for vision is one team, not going for vision is the other. Zeus is just like, hey guys, I'm here, I'm just distracting you, look at me, look at me, we were going to contest this, we're going to split lanes, no big deal. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, this isn't going towards... They're looking to get a pick. They are looking to get a pick here. Will Homicidal take the bait? Do not do it, my friend. Do not do it. Do not do it. Oh, they might have just given away their position. I think they might have rotated a little bit early. Oh. Nightmare? I'm pretty sure he can see you. All right, they gave up on it.
Yeah. Good safe positioning there from Homicidal. And, you know, when he just kind of hangs out playing safe, and they basically get a free tower top, especially when you consider that they can maintain that dominance in the top shrine potentially. They've set themselves up for an early fort already. Gamble attempted there for Vox, but even in death, I'd say they got the better end.
Yeah, not too shabby at all. Well, the plays were attempted to be made, and, you know, I really like the top pressure up here, and I think that will allow even in death to get the top temple, and it really puts a lot of pressure onto that top fort, and sometimes that can give you that early advantage, especially in lanes, mm-hmm. especially when you're going up against global with your own global. It kind of gives you this added advantage in the top lane push. It's a little bit slower to rotate down for the next laning phase, but Zeus in a little bit too far there.
Nightmare able to put some pressure on. Medivh shield has been cast. Charge in, but no stun because level 4 not locked in quite yet, so out through the portal he goes.
We'll see. We'll see if Even in Death manages to maintain that top, as right now Vox is taking the shots and there's
That's
not
a big
really
deal.
A whole lot they can do about it.
I think it's very important for Vox to have contested this shrine. 4 is here, so they're going to get a little bit more scary with that stun. There's a stun. The portal in. Feral lunge forward. Not enough for the kill on Lutana, but Varian does very much have to back away. Nightmare in for the kill. The magic missiles find the kill.
Yeah, that was huge there. Hal almost got clipped on the way out, but we see very aggressive Tychus play, and that is not necessarily Medivh's fault that he died there, because Tychus is going in, he's trying to secure the kill, so Medivh has to follow to be able to put the shield or the portals down, and wasn't able to find his way out. It was a good poly on the backside, but just not enough, and Vox played that really well.
And now Vox have all of the walls down, maybe? And that opens things up.
The Bonks take a bit of damage themselves.
Yeah, it's pretty even, actually. Bruiser camp like the, early, because they're like looking... The yeah, they want to put that pressure on with Ball Set. They want to force more than a Brightwing response.
Yeah, and the thing about this, when you take this strategy, when you get this camp early, you push in that top lane, you force them to either rotate or respond. Brightwing hasn't gotten there yet. Medivh's starting to rotate up. He's going to get that camp. But that allows you to go down, put some pressure on, and potentially get the siege camp of your own, get that tower damage. And again, the first few temple shots of the next wave will get that well down, which gives you an advantage in that temple phase. Or just they get pushed back in their lane and aren't able to do anything.
Well, we'll see. I will say this. The Medivh rotation actually forced Falstad out of the top lane, disallowing him to soak because that cat can't push it in. So it was a really nice response with that Medivh Brightwing up top, forcing Shot away, forcing Shot to play safe. As a result, I don't think the Bruiser Camp really paid off the way they were hoping for. And now they're going to have a response to the top camp Bruiser lane. Of course, Falstad does have the global. But with this well going down, that is a big win. And they force Molten Core. Oh, do they get the well? The Winions. Nice.
They got the well. The next temple phase will be spawning here any second. Falstad will be able to clean up the top. I think that camp was grabbed a little bit early. Again, you want to be able to leave the team at the top as long as you can. Have the man control that you can afford yourself. Battery, though. Power slides out.
Yeah, plenty safe. If they get that last shot on the tower for the XP. I was going to say it'll put them towards 10, but no, it's not even relevant. I don't think the mid or the bottom fort going down would still be enough for a level 10. All
right. Early shots will be channeled here by Even and Death. That's very good for them. Nightmare continuing to try and soak. Falstad not yet ready to fly down, still cleaning up. But the early shots here, not being contested again. The well is on the side of Vox.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised by their passivity here in the bottom lane. They force Tychus up, so they get a little bit more aggro once it's Tychus mid. Brightwing has phase shifted in. Portal is down, but Tychus dies mid lane to Zeratul Falstad.
Yeah, Falstad decided he'd fly down, but the power slide in. Nice cleanse there onto Daihu. That is Dark Chimera. We talked about him before and when we were in the draft, and those are the types of snap cleanses and snap plays that you expect your professional or ex-professional, however you want to look at it. I still consider him a professional. Very much on top of his game to be able to get the cleanse there.
Now, very well done. Last of the shots will go off in the bottom fort, taking it down with the assistance of Rhaegar Li Ming. And now we have level 10 on the horizon for both teams. Oh, level 10. Rag. Charge. Oh, barely unable to get that follow-up. And now, Daihu, oh, heals the Ancestral, has to be cast. Costly heroic. 100-second cooldown.
That was a big one there, but a very much needed one. But level 10 online. We do have the Mosh Pit. We have Leyline, and we've got the Sulfurous Smash Jake.
The wombos,
dude. We've got some combos on the horizon. We're going to see how quick Shot's going to be on Falstad. Just be like, wait a minute, guys. We need to try and disengage. Here's a gust. I hope we live.
Yeah, seriously. It's a tall order to get away from that. Now, Li Ming does have the interrupt as well. It's a big deal. They do have the cleanse also. So they have options. Mosh Pit isn't a game ender unless you get a God Mosh. And we've already seen a few of those in Open Division.
We saw a five-man Mosh just in the last series, which was not something you see too often. Falstad continuing to put the pressure on in the top. Got to be careful not to stay too
he's
long.
He's getting rotated on.
That is a
he's
huge
fine.
Rotation. He's like, I got a dip, guys.
Yeah, yeah. Good fly. Not taking any risks. I mean, he has Gust, but even then, that might not be enough.
Yeah, you can't just casually walk away, barrel roll, and think that you can make it. He's like, ah, and then he made the right call. Very nicely done.
I mean, as valuable as the flight cooldown is, dying is not worth it. That would quickly throw away your control on the map, quickly throw away your lead. And here we are with another shrine. So Bruiser Camp, since it was collected a bit earlier, is readily available. That's a big win for them when it comes to the timings on the map. And they have the Giants in the bottom as well right now. So in terms of the map presence, well in favor of Box.
Yeah, they do have the first fort down. I mean, you take a look at, we're 8 minutes in. We're on our third temple phase, but you know, we've only seen one fort down. Nightmare on the backside, just absolutely harassing Hal. It's like, get away, please. Wow. Brightwing.
This is going to get bad really quick, though. Those Giants have a big wave of minions in front of them in the bottom. The Bruisers are going to take care of that top fort at this rate, too. So
somebody has to go back.
Yeah, Tychus is looking to rotate. I love the fact that Vox just forced them to stay at that shrine, though. They even if they didn't get any shots, keeping them there was so valuable.
Oh! Medivh's going to come over, but they just saw Tychus up in the top clearing that. They know they have the numbers advantage. They also have the Falstad Mighty Gust, but on the other side, Medivh has a ley line. The boss is about to go down. There goes the ley line. One is down. Oh. The VP is there. Mighty Gust, but we see the flash pit. It gets interrupted. Oh my goodness.
Ancestral on the wrong target, but they still get a double kill. Homicidal getting pulled in by that whirlwind. It is working against him so hard. Oh, RNG Jesus, not on the side of Even in Death.
Wow. Even in Death used everything that they possibly could. But Wave of Four said no. Mighty Gust was there.
Yeah, Mosh didn't even go off. Played. It didn't even get cast.
Yeah, he tried to. You could hear it queue up. And then Mosh is like, nope. That's what Nido Li Ming is on point.
And like the Gust VP did have a fair bit of overlap. So but it didn't matter. It was still like plenty safe and it secluded the ETC perfectly. Alright, Ragnaros tanks a few of the shots, bottom keep down to half health. The last few shots of the mid temple did actually go to Vox as well. So now they're sitting at a pretty significant lead.
Yeah, that was an opener. That was a risky call. But again, they saw Tychus up in the top. They realized that they were already in position. But man, that's a fight. That is a true boss fight right there, where both teams just like, I've got my cards on the table. You've got your cards on the table. Let's see what happens.
Dude, I'm loving the Vox shot calling, though.
They're aggressive.
Like, the way that they opened the map with the mercs, forced a five-man fight, and then retreated and picked up that boss. Battery.
But the VP in response. Nightmare seems to be trapped in there. There he goes.
All right. Sulfur Smash, still a big threat here in this fight. They don't have the same safe setup as Leyline that they want. Still got to consider that a threat, though.
The poke from Li Ming is just turning them back in their trail. You know, it's like, guys, we're chasing. Li Ming's like, no, you're not. But Vox right now, one fort still standing, did some bottom keep damage, and they're continuing to pressure. And think about these rotations here, Jake, is that on the way out, Li Ming's like, I'm just going to throw an orb here. And that adds up to shots over time. Speaking of shots.
He soaked.
Hey, look at Chet.
He's looking for level 16. There it is. He found it.
Don't worry, guys. I got it.
So Master's Touch is done. Seasoned on its way. Unvarian on his way. Top fort will fall. Nice little chunk of XP. 15 just about to be locked in.
I could not see how dark that was watching it on Skype.
What's on Skype?
Now they have one fort.
Oh, the...
No, this is how I'm watching the game.
That's a struggle, man. Okay, keep goes down. One more shot. There it is.
Easy. Almost a little too easy. And they built themselves this lead. They built themselves the advantage, and it makes it a lot easier. Wow. I do like the call here. I actually really like the call if they decide to take that camp.
They're going to get it.
Yeah, this is,
but
this is one of the...
clean it up pretty quick.
Now, this is one of the few things that they can do. They can push this in. They're really under. They can't contest the shrine at all.
No.
They forced the back out of everybody on Vox. That's one of the few things that they could do to give themselves some type of control in this game. They're not going to get much out of it, but it allows them to clean up the lanes to soak, and it forces the rotation of Vox to dictate the pace at least for the next few seconds, because they knew they couldn't get any temple shots. So it's actually not that bad, and it's, I actually really like that call.
And it gets level 16, but the shields are in. Battery gets gusted back, and down he will fall. Tried to cast that mosh pit. Now we've got the molten core cast to try to provide some support from afar. Ah, oh, sulfurous smash.
The counter synergy.
Oh, no.
Jake, no. Oh. Sulfurous smash hit right as Leyline Seal went out. But look at this. Void Prison is here, and somebody is going to be coming out of there. Oh, the portal. Can he survive?
That hurts. That sulfurous smash would have gotten one and probably set up another kill.
Okay, so when I said that was a good call, the call isn't to stand in there until you force a team fight.
You get 16, you get a some to keep wall down, you bounce.
Yeah, it's
just a little bit of overstay from Battery on ETC.
It was a good call, but definitely stayed a little bit too long. And then the counter synergy between Smash and Leyline, that's got to feel bad.
Yeah, it's really tough to have those moments happen. But not out of it yet. One keep down on the side of Even and Death. One team fight could quickly bring things back to an even fight. It's 18 to 16. Far from favorable, but at least they're on even talent footing.
Here's the thing, is that Even and Death has to fight. There's no more, I'm going to sit here and hang out for a little bit.
Ooh.
Or they take a boss and dictate the rotations. This is one of two things that they can do. But if the middle gets channeled, that will hit the middle keep.
You know,
this will not last long.
Vox is well aware of this happening. And they're saying, that's fine, yo. We got a fort in the bottom lane. What is your boss going to do? Even if we get half the shots on one tower and the rest of the shots in the other tower, more than enough aggression.
Oh, no.
Look at this. This camp is going to threaten the top lane more than the boss will threaten the bottom.
Dark Chimera is corralled, though.
Uh-oh.
Chimera is corralled. Oh, there it is. No. Oh, they didn't land it.
He's like, I'm the sheepdog, not the sheep. And he escapes.
And they're giving up more shots middle. They gave up more shots middle. Nightmare's like, you're going to chase? Don't worry. I'm just going to come over here and grab some shots. But now we have shot flying in. Is he going to get the gust? And he doesn't need it just yet. As we see the cleanse onto ETC, who has to back away. Not very healthy. They're looking to re-engage. Nightmare.
Keeps down.
Oh, no.
Boss has made it through the keep wall in the bottom lane. But the Bruiser Camp is on the top keep while they're shooting it. That's going to be the last structure down on the side of Even and Death. And now you see Vox is looking to put the pressure on, seal the deal, find that VP to end it all.
Is this really the time?
It's only one VP.
Go in and
one target. Shields were a little late, but the portal will be enough to get Homicidal out.
Is this not a just go take the temple and win the game easy?
They'd rather throw, man.
I mean, it is a 5v4. It's
gust.
Not like you have the gust is there, but the portal. Let's see if they go in. Leyline Seal is already down. Homicidal.
Oh my goodness. They're barely living. Beautiful ancestral heal. Zoo is going to get collapsed on by that portal, but a little bit late. Master's Touch does make it do a lot more damage. And the Molten Core finding one of those kills. That Ragnaros is on the bottommost part of the map, but Fallside flies up to the top shrine to start to apply more damage as the shields start to regenerate. Nightmare!
Nightmare! Oh my
god!
Oh! Tyka says hello! He went quarterback, didn't he?
He did.
He's like, guys, check out this arm. Imagine if they had just gone to temple first, took the shields off, and a little bit of core damage.
Uh-oh.
Oh, there's the ley line! Daihoo!
8 seconds on Gus. I don't think they can save him. They got it. The body blocks weren't there because ETC power slid very anxiously.
He stood in front and took a lot of extra damage he didn't need to.
Mm.
Wow. Okay.
That's
the catapults are about to be on
top lane.
Though.
Top lane is two catas. They're fine. Brightwing's got that.
We have no keeps. It's fine. No matter what happens, Even in Death, we'll need to 100% take the next team fight and keep their fingers crossed.
Yeah.
The scary thing is that you could reasonably backdoor this. You have Zeratul, so he can go. You have Falstad that can fly in immediately. And then let's say you rotate one person casually over, like a Li Ming. I don't want to say it's the best option, but if you get desperate, I don't know. Even that was a weird boss, a weird core call.
It really was. And we'll see if it costs them the game. They're still very much ahead, but 20 is about to be locked in. Shot gusts them into the base, but the portal enough for the retreat, and then shot flying to safety. Very odd interaction that we caught the tail end of. But no one died. Two temples. This is a tough situation.
A little bit. Two temples are up. They have to go, and they have to force a fight immediately. Yes, you have stuff on your core. You have to clear it, Nightmare. And then go fight immediately.
Okay, so they reveal him. They're trying to collapse. He's just looking to stall. Li Ming is up on the top shrine. If they can just force everyone's attention. I mean, Brightwing's stuck in base pushing these mercs back. Those shields are going to fall rapidly. Tychus and Rag are making their way up, but they're split. There's a lot of indecision here on the side of even a death. A falset flying in with Zeratul.
I don't know, man.
That's game.
Okay, they're getting temple shots.
Oh. Tychus down. GG. GG.
Whew.
Game one. Goes to Vox.
Like, all right, well, just go ahead and make this interesting for Twitch. No big